And so much for fine German engineering. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these apart again and try to assemble to the front wall first. And what I'm going to try to do is find a knife that's sharp enough to cut this material, because it's a very high impact plastic. I think it may be an ABS style or variety of plastic. I'm not sure. In between that and nylon, I'll tell you that. Which is probably good. Okay. Okay, so this one's going on that side, this one's going on this side. So what we're going to try to do, get this side in here. And let's see, it's going to go this way. There's a little slot right here, right along the edge, that this side has to fit into, the edge of it. And there's no way it's going to do that. So we may have to do a cutaway here, and cut away the video too and come back. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of the edge off of this. I'm using a very sharp box cutter style knife, okay? Don't get on an airline with these. And always, as I say, cut away from your body. Never bring that knife toward your body, or you'll end up like Julia Child did after boning that chicken that time. That show scarred me for life. Okay, we're removing the, whoops, see, now I'm coming back toward my body. That's a no-no. We're going to slide it around. We'll work it down here. We're going to take that edge off as much as we can to thin that out a bit so maybe it'll go in. I'm also going to remove the inside edge on here on a little building. Cutting away from myself. I'm going to move the outer edge off it a little bit. Give it just a little bit of a bevel. Now sometimes you can just drag your knife down it like this and it'll take off a little thin bit, which will give it a bevel. How are we doing on that assembles quickly in 5 minutes deal, huh? Think we're going to get it? No. There we go. Okay, we bevel those off a little bit. Let's see if this piece will not fit in. Yeah, that's a little better. That's a little better. I think we've got one in. Let's see if we can get it pinned. Not quite. Okay, we're going to try pounding. If nothing else works, just give it a few hits. Is that in enough? There, it's in there now. Let me get a pin in it before it loosens up again. Hope you can see what I'm doing, because this has gone from a quick, easy 5 minute project to where it's going to take probably the rest of the year 2010. Okay, this one's going to the other side. There is no hinge on that the bottom on that side. But we're going to clean this one off now. I'm not cutting toward my body, I'm cutting away. Want to see any blood on YouTube. Kind of sorry this is working out like this. Don't even cut toward your hand. Always cut away. And bevel it, scrape it off. We're going to have to open the inside of this side too. Here you can watch Dan Aykroyd acting like Julia Child boning chicken if you want.
Now, for this you need a very sharp knife. Can't do nothing without a sharp knife. And you place the chicken on its stomach and cut along the backbone to the pope's nose like so. Oh, oh. Now I've done it. I've cut the dickens out of my finger. Well, I'm glad in a way this happened. You know, I spent so long time in the kitchen.
Okay, we've trimmed off this edge and this edge of the sidewall, and we've cleaned out this channel that comes down the entire building. Like I say, so much for that high quality German engineering. Here we go. That was funny. I had a Julia Child thing. It really wrecked me as a kid. I'm going to pound this in with the edge of the knife sheath here, because otherwise it's not going to go in. There we go. She's in, I believe. Now I'm going to insert pins. One and two. Hey, we did it. It's working. Now there's no problem with the back end, because it doesn't have that little channel that messes you up on the front. So the back end will go together rather quickly. Try to hold this so you can see me pin it. I'm going to pin the top on this side, and then we're going to pin the top on the other side. And the bottoms, left and right, on the inside, are just like the top. There's one in, and here's another one. Let's see if it's going to fit in. This one here is giving me a devil of a time. There we go. There we go, little building, pretty well good to go. Except for a couple of things. Now this is the front porch that needs to go on the little building. So, let's see, it's going to come on like this. It's going to hang off of here, like so. So I'm going to need more of the glue. Okay, let's get some glue on here. I hope I don't go over 10 minutes. If I do, somebody in Germany spanked me. Okay. Let's go here, like so, and the other one will go the other side. Just make sure that you have the angle so that these are at the outside of the porch and they're facing in toward the building on the bevel. Boy, that's good glue. Oh, I'm going to need a little more glue, so I'm going to have to run a glue bead right across the front, right across above front divider here. So we're just going to run a little glue bead across there. I don't think it'll take too much. It won't be too much. Enough to hold it on. And put the glue away. You don't want to be sniffing that all day. And here we go. Gonna stick the front porch on, like so. And just hope it'll rest there. And it won't. Okay, you get the general idea though, right? not gonna just rest there. These little struts have to be absolutely picture perfect. I'm gonna try it again. Get that little porch on there. A little roof. It's a little dormer roof type of thing that goes out. And that's not gonna hold either. Well, so much for that 5 minute thing, but I think you get the general idea. So then you put a roof on it. Front porch falls off, and you've got your PIKO quick kit basically good to go. I'll keep working on the roof, and you'll always have two of these little guys left, two or three in different kits. So all you can do is take them and throw them up in the air and hope they never land.
Why are you all spinning? Well, I think I'm going to go to sleep now. Bon appetit.